Hello students, I am Mary here. Welcome to 9th Maths NCERT Chapter 2 Polynomials. Today we are going to study from exercise 2.4, question 3. Find the value of k if x minus 1 is a factor of p of x in each of the following cases. So what we have to do is find the value of k we have to find out. Already given us x minus 1 is the factor. So this is the factor. For all these polynomials, we have four parts are there. So for all these, x minus 1 is the factor. So what we have to do is take the value of x and put in all these polynomials, the value of x we have to put, and then whatever the remaining ones will be the value of the k. I hope you understood. So whatever is the value of the x, we apply wherever x is there, and then the remaining answer will be the value of k. So let's do it one by one. So now x minus 1 is the factor. So that means x minus 1 equal to 0. Then x, when minus 1 comes this side, it will become plus 1. So then x value is 1. So wherever x is there, we will put 1, and then what is the answer we'll find out. So here, so in the place of x, what we have to put 1. So that means 1 square plus 1 plus k. So now 1 square will be 1 plus 1 and plus k. So now 1 plus 1 will be 2 and plus k. So now we have to find out the value of k. So k will keep it as it is, and this is a plus 2. So when you bring the plus to the other side, then it will become minus 2. So that's the value of k, that is minus 2. So now let's proceed for the second one. So 2, in the place of x, we will keep 1 square plus k. In the place of x, we will keep 1 plus root 2. 2 into 1 square will be 1 plus k into 1 will be k plus root 2. 2 into 1, 2 plus k plus root 2. So now let us keep k one side and bring all the other thing to the other side. First we will shift this one. Okay. So either you shift this side, or you can imagine equal this side. So we will write it this once again. I am writing it. 2 plus k plus root 2. Okay. So I am writing like this. So when we bring this side, we have to bring it to the other side. So we'll write k plus root 2. Now this plus 2, when comes this side, it will become minus 2. So now we will keep the k this side only, and let us bring this plus root 2 to the other side. So already we have minus 2 here. So here plus root 2 is there. So when it comes to the other side, it will become minus root 2. So now, here also minus, so let us bring the minus to the common, and 2 will keep. So when we have taken out as a common, it will become plus. So this is the answer or the value of the k. You can also write like this. This also is correct only, or else you can modify this way also. This is also correct. So now let's do the third one. So in the place of x, we have to put 1. So 1 square root 2 1 plus 1. So now 1 into 1 will be 1. So we will get only k minus, then root 2 into 1 will be root 2 plus 1. So now what we can do, keep the k one side. I'll just write down the same thing, minus root 2 plus 1. So we keep the k here only, and the other things we bring it to the other side. So when we bring it to the other side, this is in minus, so when it comes to the other side, it will become plus. So it will be root 2, because it is minus, when it comes this side, it will become plus. And this is plus, so when it comes this side, it will become minus. So this is the answer. Now let's do for the fourth one. So k place of x, we have to put 1 minus 3 1 plus k. So k 1, k into 1 square will get k only. 3 into 1 will be 3 plus k. So now here plus k, here also plus k, so we will get total 2k, then minus 3. Now let's keep this 2k as it is. When minus 3 comes to the other side, it will become plus 3. Now k we keep as it is, 3 also we keep as it is. Now 2 is in multiplication, when it comes to the other side, it will come to the division. So that's it. It's very easy concept. I hope you understood. So that's it. Thank you and God bless you.